Hello everyone, welcome back to Kiran's English Hub. So we are continuing with the summaries of 9th class English, and in this video we shall go through unit 4 reading C, that is can't climb trees anymore. Okay, yeah, so here we go. So in this lesson we see a conversation, a very good, a beautiful conversation between an aged man and a small little girl who is of like 12 to 13 years old. Okay, so the tall the little bit aged man who is in this lesson used to stay in one home, okay, when he was a child. Okay, so and now he comes to visit the house, and there he finds some other family staying. Okay, so the family's daughter is also there, or the family will not be there, so they both continue to make some conversation, and finally he leaves that home with so much of happiness by remembering all his childhood and all. Okay, yeah, let us see it very carefully. And in this lesson we usually do not find few, you know, prefix and suffix sentences, so do not miss the meaning of those dialogues here. Okay, yeah, so he stood on the grass verge by the side of the road and looking over the garden wall at the old house. So this man comes and he just stands at the edge of the grass, okay, beside the road, and just keeps on looking at the old house. It hadn't changed much. The old house did not change very much. The old house built with solid blocks of granite wasn't altered at all. Altered in the sense like remade or reconstructed. So in his childhood also the same granite plate was, the blocks were there. Now also the same granite blocks were there. So nobody rebuilt it. But there was a new outhouse. But beside that old house there is a new outhouse. Okay, outhouse in the sense the place where usually people keep things, okay, all these farming tools and all. Okay, next. And there were fewer trees. Okay, trees also were grown. Okay, next. He was glad to see that the jackfruit tree still stood at the side of the building, casting its shade on the wall. So the jackfruit tree, which is right there in front of him, was also there when he was child. So the same tree is also there still, and it is also casting its shade, okay, its shade on the wall. So he remembered his grandmother saying, his grandmother used to say something. What was that? A blessing rests on the house where the shadow of a tree falls. His grandmother used to tell him that if there is any tree beside home, and if that tree's shade casts on the wall, then that house will be blessed very much. And so the present owners must also be receiving the tree's blessing. So he imagines that the present house owners who are living there, they must also be receiving the same blessings. Next. At the spot where he stood, there had once been a turnstile, and as a boy he would swing on it, going round and round until he was quite dizzy. So the place where he stood, so there was a gate, okay, that was called as the turnstile. Turnstile in the sense, I think we all have experienced that turnstile. It's just like a round gate. Okay, so in one space of that gate, only one person can be standing and moving forward or backward. Okay, so that case, that type of gate used to be there. And as a boy, he used to, you know, climb that gate and used to make rounds on that. Okay, it just turns like a wheel. Okay, it just makes rounds. So until he becomes dizzy. Okay, dizzy in the sense, you know, just like a losing balance and all. Okay, so until he gets that type of effect, he used to make rounds on that gate. Next. Now the turnstile had gone, the opening wall up, the tall hollyhocks grew on the other side of the wall. So now that type of gate is no more, and there is a single opening gate, and there are also some plants, okay, flower plants. Okay, so there are hollyhocks in the sense like what do you call them in Telugu? Mandaram. Okay, mandaram chetlu. Okay, so the trees were there. So somebody, when he is just looking at all these things, imagining all these things and all, somebody starts to ask this question.
what are you looking at? Okay, somebody suddenly asked this question. So it was a disembodied voice. Disembodied embodied voice in the sense there was nobody, but voice was there. So moments later, a girl stood framed between dark red hollyhocks, staring at the man. So you are just waiting for the person to see, okay, the person who has asked this question. And after a few seconds, he saw a little girl standing on the other side of the wall and staring at him. And she was only 12 or 13, slim and dark, with lively eyes and long black hair. Okay, so that girl was just like 12 to 13 years old. So just like slim and having a long hair and all. Okay, so I'm looking at the house, he said. Okay, so this was the question asked. What are you looking at? He has replied as, I'm looking at the house. Okay, so you can see the house here. Okay, speaking to him. Okay, fine. Yeah. Why? Do you want to buy it? Okay, so when he said, I am just looking at the house, this girl asked, why? Do you want to buy it? Okay, so next he asked, is it your house? It's my father's. Okay, this girl said, no, it's not my house, it's my father's house. And what does your father do? He started asking question again. What does your father do? She replied, he's only a colonel. Okay, he's only a colonel. Okay, so the word here only is something like different for him. So soon after answering this, he replied as, only a colonel? Why did you say that, only a colonel? So she replied like this, well, he should have been a brigadier by now. Okay, so actually he's supposed to be a brigadier by the time, that little girl's father. That's why she said he is only a colonel. Okay, so the man burst out laughing. So the man suddenly got laughing by the way that girl speaks, and she started speaking again. It's not funny. Okay, even mommy says he should have been a brigadier. Okay, so she also is a little bit infected with the ideas of her mother. Okay, so this little girl said, even my mother also says the same thing. Okay, don't laugh. Next. It was on the tip of his tongue to make a witty remark. Okay, perhaps that's why he's still a colonial. Okay, so because of some witty remark, he might be having some, you know, backdrop, and he might be in that position still. But he did not want to give offense. This man also wanted to ask whether the daughter's father, that little girl's father, made some mistake or like that. But he didn't want to make some type of offense on the little girl's father. So he did not speak anything, this man. So they stood on the either side of the wall, appraising each other. Okay, so that girl was standing on the other side of the wall, this man is standing outside of the wall, and they both, like, you know, exchanging their conversation like this. Okay, next. Well, she said finally, if you don't want to buy the house, what are you looking at? So when she asked, do you want to buy the house, this man said, no, I don't want. So she finally asked, then if you don't want to buy a house, why are you looking at the house? So I used to live here once. Okay, so this man said, I am just looking at the house because, you know, I used to live in this place, in the same house once upon a time. Oh, okay, she said, oh, 25 years ago, as a boy, as a young man, and then my grandmother died, and we sold the house and went away. So this man said, so I used to live here 25 years ago, so I was a small boy. And when my grandmother died, we sold this house and we went to another place. Okay, so she was silent for a while, taking this information. So then she said, and you would like to buy it back now, but you don't have the money? It did not look very prosperous. Okay, so this girl again started speaking. So you used to live here once upon a time, and you want to buy it, do you want to buy it back now? And you don't have the money, I think. Okay, so since this man was looking little bit poor, okay, little bit poor, prosperous in the sense rich, okay, since this man is not looking very much rich, she is like thinking like that man wants to buy the house, but he doesn't have the money. Okay, she is thinking like that. No, I wasn't thinking of buying it back. Wanted to see it again, that's all. How long have you lived in it? Okay, so this man said, no, I don't have any idea of buying it again. I just wanted to see the house again, so that's why I came to see. Okay, fine, no problem. And how long have you been living in this house? Only 3 years, she smiled. Okay, she said, since only 3 years we are living in this house. And she would been eating a melon, and there was still juice in the corners of her mouth. So this little girl was also eating melon, and she might be eating melon, okay, before she could come out. So when she was speaking to this man could see some juice on the corners of her mouth. Okay, so would you like to come in and look more closely? She said, that girl said, okay, you just came to see the house, right? So do you want to come in and look a little bit closely? Okay, so wouldn't your parents mind? This man asked again. So okay, fine, I will come in, but won't your parents say anything to you like that? So they have gone to the club, they won't mind. I am allowed to bring my friends home. So this girl said, no, don't worry, they went to the club, so they won't mind. They won't mind in the sense they won't scold me or, you know, beat me, nothing. And also I am allowed to bring my friends home. Okay, I'm allowed to bring my friends home. So she started to call him as friend also. So even elderly friends like me, he asked. Okay, friends are okay, but I'm a little bit elder, no? Is it okay for you? Okay, so how old are you? Oh, just middle aged, but feeling young today. This man, the girl asked, okay, fine, but how old are you? Okay, so this man said, I am just like a middle aged man, but I'm feeling young today. Why? After looking back at the house and the place where he used to live when he was young, you know, this man brought all the memories of his childhood, and he's just feeling like he's a young man. And to prove it, he decided he would climb over the wall instead of going around to the gate. So he got up on the wall, all right, but had to rest there, breathing heavily. So this man wanted to prove that he has become young today. And this man, instead of going through the gate, he just climbed the wall and wanted to jump. Okay, so when he climbed the wall, he was completely out of his breath. So he just stayed on the wall for some time to take the breath. Okay, so middle-aged man on the flying trapeze, he muttered to himself. Okay, so he's making joke of himself, saying that middle-aged man is just like a, you know, in a swinging situation on the wall. Okay, so I will help you, she said, and gave him her hand. Okay, so when he was just like struggling to get down, she said, okay, I will help you, and she also gave her hand. Okay, so kind. Okay, next, he slithered down into a flower bed, shattering the stem of a hollyhock. So slithered in the sense he just like sliding. Okay, just sliding from the top to the down. He just started to get down off the wall, and while he was getting down, he also broke a stem of the hollyhock. Okay, next. As they walked across the grass, he spotted a stone bench under a mango tree. Stone bench under a mango tree. So he was, as he got off the wall and as he was walking, you know, inside, he also saw a stone bench. Okay, so it was the bench on which his grandmother used to rest when she was tired of burning rose bushes and bougainvillea. Okay, so these are the plant names. Okay, these are the plant names. So his grandmother, she used to rest on that stone bench whenever she is tired of, you know, burning all that, you know, burning in the sense there's like trimming, making clean all the plants and all. So whenever his grandmother was tired, she used to just take rest on that stone bench. Okay, let's just sit here, he said. I don't want to go inside. He said, okay, fine, let us sit on this bench only. I don't want to go so much inside. Okay, so she sat beside him on the bench. So it was March and the mango tree was in blossom. A sweet, rather heavy fragrance drenched the garden. Okay, so as they sat on the stone bench, it was a month of March. So in the month of March we get the mangoes. Okay, mangoes, flowers, everything, they just start to bloom at that time. So since it was that season, the mango fragrance, everything was there on the garden. So whole garden is filled with the mango fragrance and all. Okay, so they were silent for some time. So they sat there for some time with silence. Okay, so the man closed his eyes and remembered other times, the music of piano, the chiming of grandfather's clock, the constant twitter of brigadier Budgerier's on the veranda. Okay, this is the bird name, a small, it is just like a parrot. Okay, it is just like a parrot. Okay, so on the veranda, his grandfather's cranking up the old car. Okay, so as they both sat on the stone bench, this man closed his eyes and he started to remember you know, his grandfather, his grandmother, the things that they used to do, the twittering. Okay, twittering in the sense the chirping of the birds, making sounds of the birds and all. So all the noises, all those works, he started to remember by closing his eyes. Okay, so I used to climb the jackfruit tree, he said, opening his eyes. I didn't like the jackfruit though, do you? So as he started to open his eyes, he also said, I used to climb the jackfruit tree, but I don't like jackfruits. Okay, do you? Okay, do you? He asked the other, the girl. Okay, do you like? Okay, it is all right in the pickles. Okay, so this girl said, okay, it's fine in the pickles. Okay, so if you make into pickles, that it is fine to eat, it is tasty. I suppose so. The tree was easy to climb. I spent a lot of time in it. This man said, I supposed to eat the jackfruit, you know, in the pickles, but I couldn't. And that he also started saying the tree was very easy to climb, and he also spent a lot of time on the tree. So do you want to climb it again? My parents won't mind, the girl asked. So you spent a lot of time on the tree, no? So do you want to climb the tree again? And don't worry, my parents won't tell anything. Okay, so no, not after climbing the garden wall. So this man is tired of climbing the wall only, so now he doesn't want to climb the tree. Let's just sit here for a few minutes and talk. I mentioned the jackfruit tree because it was my favorite place. Okay, so no, I don't want to climb the tree. Just let us sit here and let us speak for some time, no worries. And he also said, he mentioned that jackfruit tree because it was his favorite place. And do you see that thick branch stretching out over the roof? Half the way along it, there is a small hollow in which I used to keep some of my treasures. And this man started speaking, see, do you see that branch which is over the wall? So there is a small hollow in the sense, you know, gap. Okay, some type of gap in the trees. I think you have experienced that, you have seen that. Okay, so that gap used to be there. So I used to save or keep my treasures. So in the childhood, whatever we feel most treasurable, we keep in some secret place. So this hollow of a tree is a secret for a secret place for this boy when he was child. So what kind of treasures? This girl asked like this. So, oh, nothing very valuable. Okay, he started saying, no, it's nothing valuable. Marbles I would own. Okay, marbles in the sense of the stones and all. And a book I wasn't supposed to read. He doesn't want to read a book, and he used to keep that book also. A few old coins that I would collected. Okay, and he used to place few old coins also in that hollow. Things came and went. Okay, so many things he used to keep there and many things he used to take back. So I was a bit of a crow, you know, collecting bright things and putting them away. Okay, so he was acting like a crow when he was a child. It's like bringing bright things and keeping there and some of them taking back. Okay, next. There was my grandfather's iron cross. Well, not my grandfather's exactly, because he was British and the iron cross was a German decoration awarded for bravery during the war, the First World War. When my grandfather fought in France, he got it from the German soldier. Okay, so his grandfather was a German. Actually, his grandfather was a British. So when he was fighting with the German soldiers and all, his grandfather was awarded the bravery award. Okay, so bravery award was usually with the iron cross. Okay, so the same cross which you can see on the dress of Hitler also. Okay, that is awarded for bravery. Okay, so when his grandfather was in the army of Germany, so German soldiers, his grandfather was also awarded that cross of bravery. Okay, so he even kept that
award also in that Halo tree only. So dead or alive? This girl immediately asked, is he dead or alive? Okay, I beg your pardon. Oh, you mean the German? I never asked. Dead, I suppose. Or perhaps he was a prisoner. I never asked grandfather. Isn't that strange? Okay. So when this girl asked dead or alive, she starts saying, oh, that man. Oh, no, no, no. I don't know. Actually, I think was just like fighting for the country. And I didn't know whether he was put in the prison and all. I didn't ask my grandfather. It is just like a strange. Okay. It is just like a strange. Okay. So, and the iron cross, do you still have it? No, he said, looking her in the eyes. I left it in the jackfruit tree. And she also immediately asked, what about the iron cross? Okay, is it still with you? So this man said, I don't know about it. I just kept in that hallow of the jack tree. I don't know whether it is there or not. You left it in the tree? Yes. I was so excited at the time, packing and saying goodbye to people and thinking about the ship I was going to sail on that. I simply forgot all about it. So I said, of course, I kept it in the hollow of the tree only. And also I forgot to take it because I was completely busy with packing things, you know, and he was about to go by the ship. Okay. So he is so much interested to go by the ship. So I was just thinking about that only and he forgot that iron cross. So she was silent, considering her fingers on lips, her gaze fixed on the jackfruit tree. Then quietly she said, it may still be there in the hollow of the branch. Okay, so this girl, you know, just like thinking, she was just sitting there and she also was placing her fingers on the lips. Okay, just like indication of thinking. And she was just gazing in the sense of looking towards the jackfruit tree. And she quietly slowly said, I think it is still there. Okay, it might be still there in the hollow of the branch only. And yes, he said, it's 25 years, but it may still be there unless someone else found it. Okay, so that man continued, yes, it might be still there. It is nearly 25 years. Okay, but it might be still there unless someone takes it. Okay, next. Would you like to go and look? That girl immediately said, do you want to just go and look if it is there or not? This man said, no, I can't climb trees anymore. So this is the title of our text. Okay. Yeah. Next. If you can't, I will go and see. You just sit here and wait for me. So this girl said, okay, fine. If you don't climb also, no worries. I will just go and see if it is there or not. So she sprang up and ran across the grass, swift and sweet of limb. Soon she was in the jackfruit tree, crawling along the projecting branch. A warm wind brought little eddies of dust along the road. Summer was in the air. Okay, so as soon as she wanted to pick that cross of bravery, so she just immediately got down off that bench and she ran towards the jackfruit tree and started to climb the tree. And she climbed the jackfruit tree, and since it is just like summer, it is just like a little bit dusty and all, and all the, you know, eddies in the sense, just like the round of the air which is in dust and all, that small wind circles are going on around the area and all. So the summer was completely there, and this girl climbed the tree. Okay, so you can see here in the picture, this man just sitting in the rock chair there, and this girl almost climbed the tree. So I have found it, she cried. I have found something. Okay, cried in the sense shouted. Okay, so she shouted, I have found. And now barefoot she ran breathlessly towards him in her outstretched hand and rusty old medal. Okay, so outstretched in the sense, you know, stretching like this straight. So she just got down from the tree and she just holding that medal in the hand, stretching like this, and she ran towards him. Okay, barefoot in a sense, without having any chappal, okay, footwear like that. So he took it from her and turned it over on his palms. Okay, so he started looking at that medal, iron cross. Okay, so is it the iron cross? She asked eagerly. She is very much interested to
get information. Okay, she said, is it the iron cross you kept there? Okay, yes, he said, it is. Okay, now I know why you came. You wanted to see it, if it was still there on the tree. Okay, so after he said yes, this girl is thinking that this man has come to that house just to find this cross. Okay, so she said also, no, you might be right. I'm not really sure why I came, but you can keep the cross. You found it after all. Okay, so this man said, okay, fine, you might think it like that, but of course, that might be also true. I don't know, but since you found this iron cross, we can keep this iron cross. Okay, no, you keep it, it's yours. The girl said, no, I shouldn't keep it. This is your cross, your grandfather's cross, so you should keep it. But it could have remained in the tree for another 25 years if you hadn't climbed up to look for it. Okay, so this man said, no, it should be there only, because if you don't find it now, it should have been there for another 25 years more also. So we do not know, that's why you just let it be there, you keep it with you. But if you hadn't come back again, okay, so this girl said, but if you hadn't come back again, this might have been lost somewhere. Okay, if you don't come in the future also, this cross would have lost, or it would have taken by someone else. Okay, so on the right day, at the right time, with the right person, he said, okay, so it might be taken, but that would have been taken by right person at right time and at right place. So getting up and placing the medal in her hands, it wasn't the cross I came for, it was my youth. Okay, so he didn't come for the cross. He said, I didn't come for the cross, I just came for my youth. Youth in the sense, all the memories, all the times he spent in that house and all. So he wanted to recollect all the memories. Okay, that's why he came there. Next, she didn't understand that, but she walked with him to the gate and stood there gazing after him as he walked away. Actually, she didn't understand when he said, I didn't come for the iron cross, I came for my youth. Okay, actually that girl is very small and unable to understand some statements which are completely different. Okay, so though she didn't understand, as he was just standing and walking towards the gate, she also just walked beside him and just looked at him. Still he walked away. So where the road turned, he looked back and waved to her. So after just getting onto the road, till the road ends, before the road could end, he just turned back and waved his hand back to her. So then he quickened his steps and moved briskly towards the bus stop. Okay, briskly in the sense, he is not interested to walk. He is not happy to walk towards the bus stop. He doesn't want to leave that place, but he had to. So after waving hand to the little girl, he just turned back and started to walk. Okay, next, there was sprightliness. Okay, sprightliness in his step. And something cried aloud in his heart. Okay, so he just has lot of energy. Okay, lot of energy in his body, because he had gathered all his memories back. He had experienced all his youth back. So because of that, he has so much of energy again in his body. And his heart also, something cried aloud in his heart. Okay, cried in the sense, so much happy. Okay, he is so much in his, he is very much happy. And sometimes when you are unable to express our happiness, we express that happiness in our heart only. So expressed in his happiness like that in his heart. Next, dark, dancing eyes, melon sweet lips, limbsome limbs. Okay, so dark, dancing eyes in the sense, that girl's dark, dancing eyes, and melon sweet lips. Okay, the sweet little words that the little girl spoke, and limbsome limbs. Okay, like limbsome in the sense, just like slim, graceful limbs in the sense, legs and all. Okay, so this expresses the imagery of that little girl. So the mango scented summer breeze made the blood course in his veins, and he forgot for a moment that he couldn't climb trees anymore. So all that imagery of the girl, the little girl's eyes, the little girl's words, the little girl's running here and there, and that mango smell also, which is the mango perfume also, which is there over the garden. Everything that made this man to forget his middle-aged, middle-aged, the age that he has. Okay, so sometimes at a moment suddenly he felt like he has come to his youth. Okay, he has become a small child, and he also forgot that he cannot climb trees anymore. Okay, so just imagine that if we are back to our roots, okay, if we are back to our youth, if we are back to our childhood, okay, so we would also become more joyable. Just imagine your childhood close for some time, imagine your childhood, and you might find it very much beautiful, and you will also feel so much energetic when you remember it. Okay, so just like that only this man also remembered all his childhood days, and he has enjoyed that little bit of time with this little sweet girl. Next, it is written by Ruskin Bond, very influential and famous poet. Okay, yeah, Ruskin Bond was born in Kasauli, Himachal Pradesh in 1934. He wrote a number of short stories, essays, novels, and many books for children. The Room on the Roof was his first novel, written when he was 17. When he was in his 17 years old, he has written this novel. Remember. Next, it received the John Llewellyn Rice Memorial Prize in 1957. In 1992, he received the Sahitya Academy Award for his short story collection, Our Trees Still Grow in Dehra, given by the Sahitya Academy, India's National Academy of Literature. Next, he was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999 for contribution to children's literature. Okay, so if possible, children, you can read Ruskin Bond's poems, novels, stories also. So they are very much, beautiful. You will enjoy them. Okay, next, we have glossary here. Yeah, trencel, a mechanical gate consisting of revolving horizontal arms fixed to a vertical post, allowing only one person at a time to pass through. Next, dizzy, that is adjective, having a sensation of spinning around and losing one's balance. Next, hollyhock, a tall garden plant where large showy flowers. Next, disembodied, lacking any obvious physical source. Next, trapeze, a swing used by circus acrobats. Next, bougainvillea, okay, an ornamental shrubby climbing plant widely cultivated in the tropics with bright colored flowers. Okay, that is a plant name. Okay, next, brigadier, a small bird carrier, a small bird belonging to the parrot family. This bird is just like parrot only. It has a little bit yellow and little bit brown feathers. Okay, so that is very sweet bird. Okay, next, eddy, a circular movement of dust. Next, sprightliness, liveliness, and energy in action. Next, limpsome, slim, graceful, coarse, flow. Okay, so these are the meanings glossary that we have. And this is the your reading C for we have in unit 4. Okay, so as we have environment as a theme for this whole unit, we are completing this particular unit with so much of happiness of these trees and all. Okay, yeah, fine. So in the next videos we shall go through unit 5 of reading A. And before leaving the video, do not forget to subscribe to my channel so that you will get all the notifications when I upload the further videos. And do not forget to visit my playlist. There you will find all the videos from unit 1 to unit 8, from class 6 to class 10th. So most of the viewers are commenting me, asking for the further videos and all, so they are missing the to go through the playlist. So just visit my playlist, you will find all the videos there, and you can enjoy all the lessons. Yeah, see you all in the next video. Until then, God bless you, take care.